Welcome back, friends. Today we are going to study about the bevel gears, right? We had already studied about two different kind of gears, like helical gears and spur gears. Now today we are going to study about the bevel gears, in where the bevel gears are used to transmit the power at constant velocity ratio between two shafts whose axes intersect at a certain angle, right? Means the bevel gears, we have to transmit a power between two shafts in which axis does not parallel but intersecting at an angle. We are using the spur gear and helical gears in which the shafts axis are parallel. If the shafts axis are not parallel and intersecting at an angle, then we cannot use the spur gears and helical gear to transmit the power, right? So the pitch surface for the bevel gears are frustum of cones. The two pairs of cones in contact, like shown in this figure, right, which is shown in this figure, also the elements of the cones, means if the first shaft is the horizontal plane and second shaft is on the vertical plane, then two shafts axis are intersecting at the 90 degree, then we have to use the bevel gears to transfer the power, right, or transmit the power. Since the radius of the both gears are proportional to their distances from the apex, therefore the cones may roll together without sliding, right? Next, we have to classify the action of the bevel gears, like mitre gears, angular bevel gears, right? When the equal bevel gears contact two shafts whose axes intersect at the right angle, means the two shafts having an angle between two is a 90 degree, then the gears are called as the Meyer gears. The angular bevel gears, when the bevel gears connect two shafts whose axes intersect an angle other than the right angle, then they are known as the angular bevel gear. Next one is the crown bevel gear. When the bevel gears connect two shafts whose axes intersect an angle greater than the right angle, right, then the bevel gears is called as the crown bevel gears. Also the internal bevel gears, when the teeth of the bevel gears are cut on the inside of the pitch cone, then they are known as the internal bevel gears, right? Now the terms used in bevel gears. The terms which are used in bevel gears are as exactly same as the terms which are used in the spur gear and helical gear. But the differences means the same, some differences are there. Like if we are using the pitch, right? If we are using the pitch circle diameter module, so there are the different kind of parameters are included in pitch. Pitch circle diameter also in the module, right? As like the module are module for the spur gear and module for the helical gears are different. Like for the spur gear, the module is going to be M, but for the helical gear, the module M is going to be converted into the M cos beta, right? Similarly, here the module, speech, pitch circle diameter, the equations are changed, but the terminology is going to be similar. The definitions for the pitch circle diameter and module is going to be similar, but the value, if we are going to find the mathematical relation, then the mathematical relation for the all the terminology is going to be different. First, pitch cone. It is the cone connecting the pitch element of the teeth is called as the pitch cone. Pitch angle. It is the angle, maybe the pitch line with the axis of the shaft is denoted by theta p, cone distance. It is the length of the pitch cone element. It is also called as the pitch cone radius, and it is a dp by 2 divided by sine theta p s, right? Means here the cone distance is measured as the op, right, which is here the o is here and p is here, means this is the op, right? Means where the two teeth is going to be intersect, or you can say the where the mating teeth are available. First, here is the vertical gear and here is the horizontal gear. So the two teeth is going to be mating here. right? So the outer point of the matting gear is called as the P, and the distance from the center, is called as the con distance. Or you can say is the con pitch, con radius, right? Addendum angle. It is the angle subtended by the addendum of the tooth at the con center. So the addendum A is going to be 10 inverse A divided by OP, right? Also the dedendum angle is going to be beta. It's going to be 10 inverse D upon OP, right? Same the face angle. It is the angle subtended by the face of the tooth at the con center. So this is the terminologies which you should have to remember for the derivation or for the design of the bevel gear, right? Now the determination of the pitch angle for the bevel gear, right? How we are going to be determined, or how we are going to be solve the pitch angle for the bevel gear? So first, theta P1 is the pitch angle for the pinion. Theta P2 is going to be pitch angle for the gear, as the theta S is the angle between two shafts axis, right? Same the DP. DP is the diameter of the pinion, means the pitch diameter of the pinion. DG is the pitch diameter of the gear, and VR is the velocity ratio, is DG upon DP is equal to TG upon TP is equal to NP upon NG. All this, right? Now, from the terminology of the figure, we have find that the total angle between two shaft theta S is going to be the angle of the pinion plus the angle of the gear. So the summation of the pitch angle of the pinion and pitch angle of the gear is going to be total angle between two shafts is theta S is equal to theta P1 plus theta P2, or you can say is the theta P2 is equal to theta S minus theta P1. Same as if we are going to use the sine angle, then the sine theta P2 is equal to sine theta S minus theta P1. If we are going to solve the sine theta P theta S minus theta P1, so the equation is sine cos minus cos sine, right? Means the SC minus CS. So sine theta S cos theta P1 minus cos theta S into sine theta P1. We know that the con distance is OP is equal to DP by 2 divided by sine theta P1. Similar for the gear is equal to DG upon 2 divided by sine theta P by 2. So from this equation, we have the sine theta P2 divided by sine theta P1 is equal to DG upon DP. It's a velocity ratio. So we can write as sine theta P2 is equal to VR into sine theta P1, right? So we are going to put the value of sine theta P2 is equal to velocity ratio into sine theta P1 is equal to sine theta S into sine theta P1 minus cos theta S into sine theta P1, right? If we are going to divide by cos theta P1 at the both side, then we have the VR tan theta P1 is equal to sine theta S minus cos theta S into tan theta P1. So we have the tan theta P1 equal to sine theta S divided by VR plus cos theta S. How? So we are going here, we are going to put this cos theta S into tan theta P1 on the other side. Then the minus sign is going to be plus, right? If we are move this cos theta S into tan theta P1 left side of the equation, then the minus sign is going to be plus. So the sine theta S is equal to VR tan theta P1 plus cos theta S tan theta P1. So we are going to common the tan theta P1 from this equation. We have the tan theta P1 in bracket VR plus cos theta S. Now if we are going to subject the tan theta P1, so we have the equation tan theta P1 is equal to sine theta S divided by VR plus cos theta S. Now the theta P1 is equal to tan inverse sine theta S divided by VR plus cos theta S. Similarly, we can find if we are putting the value of sine theta P1 is equal to sine theta P2 divided by VR in the equation of number one, right? If you are putting the value of sine theta theta p1 in this equation, then we have sine theta p2 equal to sine theta s into cos theta p1 minus cos theta s into sine theta p2 divided by vr. After solving that equation, we have this tan theta p2 is equal to sine theta s divided by 1 upon vr plus cos theta s. So the equation of this theta ps is equal to tan inverse sine theta s divided by 1 upon vr plus cos theta s, right? So the condition is, when the angle between the shaft axis is 90 degree, then the total angle theta s is going to be 90. For the total angle theta s is 90, so the value of sine 90 is going to be 1. So the equation of this sine theta p1, so the equation theta p1 is going to be tan inverse 1 upon vr is equal to tan inverse dp upon dg, where dp upon dg is equal to tp upon tg and mg upon np, which is the velocity ratio, right? So theta p2 is equal to tan inverse vr, right? Tan inverse vr is equal to tan inverse dg upon dp is equal to tan inverse tg upon tp is equal to tan inverse tp upon ng, right? Or you can say the np upon ng, right? Proportion for the bevel gear as the addendum is equal to 1m. Addendum is equal to 1 module. Dedendum is equal to 1.2m, means 1.2 module. Clearance is equal to 0.2 module. And working depth is equal to 2 module. And also the thickness of the tooth is equal to 1.5708 module. These five equations, five proportion for the design of the bevel gear, you have to remember this equation. Whenever you ask in the example, you have to solve this all values with using this equation. Now, the formative or equivalent number of the teeth for the bevel gear by using Tredgold's approx section, right? Approximations. We have already discussed that the involute teeth for the spur gear may be generated by the edge of the plane as it rolls on the base cylinder. Right, means this theory is going to be discussed in our previous lecture for the design of the virtual number of teeth on the helical gear. So we have already discussed about the generating of the involute teeth on the generated by the edge of the plane as it rolls on the base cylinder. So we can find the virtual number of teeth on the helical gear, same as we are going to use those theory for the formative or equivalent number of the teeth on the bevel gear. So in this figure, the theta p is the pitch angle or half of the cone angle, r is the pitch circle radius of the bevel or bevel pinion or gear, and ra is the back cone distance or equivalent pitch circle radius of spur pinion or gear. Similarly, Ra is equal to R sec theta p. How? So here, from this figure, we have Rb, right, which is the back cone distance. R is the pitch circle radius for the pinion as well as the gear. The angle is theta p. So the relation between R and Rb, where the Rb is going to be a hypotenuse and R is the side, right? So we have the equation is Rb is equal to R sec theta p. Similarly, we know that the equivalent of number of teeth, TE, number of teeth is equal to pitch circle diameter divided by module, right? So the pitch circle diameter, we have the pitch radius is equal to Rb. We have the pitch radius is the Rb, so the diameter is 2Rb divided by m, which is the module. Now the equation of the Rb is R sec theta p. So the equivalent number of teeth on the bevel gear is going to be 2R sec theta p divided by m, where m is equal to t sec theta into p, where t is the actual number of the teeth on the gear, where the T is the actual number of teeth on the gear. So T is equal to 2R upon M, right? The actual number of teeth is equal to 2R which is r is the pitch circle radius, actual pitch circle radius. So the pitch circle actual pitch circle diameter is a d, means the 2r, 2r upon m is equal to capital T. So the T sec theta p, right? So from note that the action of the bevel gears will be same as that of equivalent spur gears, right? Since the equivalent number of teeth is always greater than the actual number of teeth, therefore a given pair of bevel gears will have a larger contact ratio. Thus, they will run more smoothly than a pair of spur gears with the same number of teeth, right? Now we are going to discuss about the strength of bevel gear. The strength of the bevel gear tooth is obtained in a similar way as discussed in previous articles or previous theory. The modified form of Lewis equation for the tangential load is given as follow, right? So the Lewis equation is used to design or to use to find the strength of the gears, as well as spur gears, helical gears, bevel gears and worm gears, right? But the equation of the Lewis, which is used in spur gears, is going to be modified each and every time if we are use the different gears like helical gears, bevel gears and worm gears. Now we are going to use the bevel gears. We have to find the strength of the bevel gears. So the equation of the Lewis, strength of bevel gears, as we discussed that the strength of bevel gears is going to be described or is going to be determined as per the Lewis equation, right? The Lewis equation is going to be used to describe or define the strength of gears, as well as spur gears, helical gears, bevel gears and worm gears. But the Lewis equation is used or is formed for the spur gear. So if we are going to use a different gears like helical gears, bevel gears and worm gears, then we have to use the modified Lewis equation, or we have to change in the Lewis equation as the terminology is going to be changed. Like now if we are use the tangential tooth load WT is for this bevel gear is sigma 0 into C BV pi M Y dash L minus B upon L, right? Which is Y dash, in this equation Y dash is the tooth form factor for the equivalent number of teeth, right? In this equation, the Y dash is the tooth form factor where the spur gear is the Y, right? The Y is the tooth form factor for the spur gear, but it's the actual number of teeth for the spur gear. But here we are using the bevel gear. Then in the bevel gear, the Y dash is the tooth form factor for the equivalent number of teeth. So the sigma 0 is the allowable static stress, CV is the velocity factor, which is 3 upon 3 plus V for the teeth cut from cutters, and 6 upon 6 plus V for the teeth generated with precision machines, where V is the peripheral speed in meter per second, B is the phase width and M is the module, where L is the slant height of the pitch cone, which is taken as under root dg upon 2 whole square plus dp upon 2 whole square, right? Now the factor L minus B upon L may be called as the bevel factor. For satisfactory operation of the bevel gear, the face width should be from 6.3 module to 9.5 module, right? Also, the ratio of L upon B should not be exceed from 3. For this, number of teeth in the pinion must not less than 48 upon under root 1 plus VR whole square. So VR is the required velocity ratio. Third condition is the dynamic load for the bevel gear may be obtained in the similar manner as discussed. If for spur gear, the static tooth load for endurance strength of the tooth for bevel gear is given by WS is equal to sigma e b pi m y dash l minus b upon l. So the value of the flexural endurance limit sigma e may be taken from the design data book in spur gear. The maximum or limiting load for wear for bevel gears is given by W wear is equal to dp into b into q into k divided by cos theta b 1, right, where the dp, b, q and k have usual meaning as discussed in spur gears, except that q is based on formative or equivalent number of teeth such that the q is equal to 2teg divided by 2 divided by teg plus tep, right? So this is the strength of for the bevel gear, right? So for the bevel gears we are going to use directly equation, not we are not going to derive any kind of equation for the strength of the gears, also the wear load which is acting on the bevel gears, and as well as the static load and the q, right, which is based on the formative equivalent number of teeth. So we are not going to derive any kind of theory from the bevel gears. You have asked always most probably examples in your GDU exams, right? So you have focused on solving the number of examples. Now we are going to study about the forces which are acting on the bevel gear. Consider a bevel gear and pinion in a mesh as shown in figure, right, like this. The normal force Wn on the tooth is perpendicular to the tooth profile, thus makes an angle equal to the pressure angle, right, to the pitch circle. This normal force can be resolved in two components. One is tangential and second is the radial component, right? Now the force, normal force Wn, which is generated on at the equal angle as the pressure angle, then the two components which are acting on the tooth is Wt and Wr as this formation, or you can say the value of the Wt is the cosine of the normal force and the radial force is the sine of the normal force. Means the Wt is that is equal to Wn cos phi and Wr is equal to Wn sin phi. So similar, if we use the ratio of the components, the ratio of the component which are Wt 10 5, like if you are putting the value of Wn in the Wr is equal to Wn sin 5, like the value of Wn is equal to Wt upon cos 5. If you are putting here value, then Wr is equal to Wn upon cos Wt upon cos 5. So the equation is going to be Wt cos 10 5. Now these forces which are acting on the bevel gear, we are going to study in our next lecture.